Deutschland, I'm Samantha Bee. Don't miss Full Frontal, only on TNT Comedy. Last week in Nevada, the endless Thanksgiving dinner that is the Democratic primary devolved into chaos and recrimination, with one side crying shenanigans and the other crying, please stop calling my cell phone and threatening my family, oh God.
Threats made against the state's party chairwoman. Here are just a couple of the voicemails she received.
You are a sick, twisted piece of shit, and I hope you'll burn for this.
You f***ing stupid bitch, what the hell are you doing? You're a f***ing corrupt bitch.
We probably just guaranteed fires in Philadelphia.
People like you should be hung in a public execution to show this world that we won't stand for this sort of corruption.
That is so wrong. It's hanged. And if this is your plan to win over the party establishment, I think you should stop reading old issues of Maxim and read the convention rules instead. Yes, the Democratic Party's growing, festering tension pimple finally came to a head when angry Sanders supporters turned Nevada's Democratic convention into a something, a fracas, Donnybrook. Apparently, that's what you call civil unrest when it involves white people. The not riot erupted over misunderstandings and objections to some of Nevada's truly arcane f***ed up rules. See, back in February, Hillary Clinton won the Nevada caucus, the closest thing Nevada has to a popular vote, except when the AVN awards come to town. By the way, also rigged, they never count the absentee ballots, or so I'm told. Hillary got 13 delegates to the Democratic National Convention and Bernie got 10. But the wheels of American democracy weren't yet done wasting our time because for some goddamn reason, Nevada also has county level conventions, and here's where the Clinton campaign shit the bed. Lots of her supporters didn't show up, particularly in Nevada's most populous county, the one with Las Vegas in it. Look, they're old. They probably got lured away to see Wayne Newton's new face. The Sanders campaign very smartly got a ton of their people to Clark County, which enabled him to pull ahead of Hillary in state delegates, even though he'd lost the popular vote, which is totally fine when Bernie does it, so shut up. But that's when Lady Luck said, I'm with her. Apparently, it's hard to get would-be delegates to fill out paperwork when they're in the midst of a screaming burngasm.
Sanders supporters accused state party leaders of putting them at a disadvantage and by rules votes and by disqualifying 58 would-be Sanders delegates. State party officials say the would-be delegates did not provide acceptable identification and did not meet the deadline to register as Democrats.
I'm sorry, guys. A game's not rigged against you just because you refuse to play it. 50 of those 58 didn't even show up at the convention, along with nearly 500 other Sanders delegates who, unlike Clinton's people, were beset by strange difficulties.
Additionally, some people were not even allowed to come into the convention because they didn't get there on time. Now, the reason they didn't get there on time is because the parking was full and the Paris Hotel didn't put up any signs to indicate that the parking was full. And so you had people that were driving around literally for an hour to find a parking spot.
Sorry, which part isn't fair? That a lot of people showed up at a convention or that it started at a time? You know, if there were actual misconduct by party officials, I'd be furious too. But ask yourself, what makes more sense? That party chair Lang changed the rules to disqualify Sanders delegates, 50 of whom Hillary Clinton had drugged and tied up in a basement with a skeleton of Vince Foster? Or that first-time delegates backing a guy who became a Democrat just before breakfast couldn't get their shit together? I don't know. Let's ask a Bernie supporter at the Nevada convention.
No! No!
There she blows. Now, I don't want to exaggerate the chaos, so let me say that despite the media's claims, I've seen no evidence that chairs were thrown. See, this guy only raised a chair. He didn't throw it. Maybe he thought he was at a Jewish wedding. Look, guys, I appreciate that you want Bernie to be president, and why wouldn't you? He's the only hopeful who already looks like he belongs on money. Should the Democratic Party make its primary process more democratic? God, yes. But the fact is, nobody stole the Nevada election. Sanders just got beat, just like he did in New York, Georgia, Texas, Florida, most open primaries, most closed primaries, and the popular vote. I'm sad to report he even lost the Great British Bake Off. That woman has 25 years practice baking goddamn cookies. You know, I love the passion of Sanders supporters, but why is it curdling into rage at their own party? Who's giving them the idea that any outcome they don't like is illegitimate and rigged?
We talk about a rigged system.
What went on in Nevada in terms of the process at the convention, it was clearly hijacked by the chair. It was a completely undemocratic process.
Uh-huh. And this coordinated election heist is being pulled off by the DNC, the group that can't find their own caucus with two hands and a map? If they had half the skill you're giving them credit for, Congress wouldn't be controlled by a live-action Dilbert and a human protein shake. The Sanders campaign used to have a great message, but lately their loudest message seems to be this.
Why am I persecuted?
Don't be that guy.